drive the old work truck out to Darlington. So it's about a 2.5 hour ride for me. I'm gonna go ahead and drive. Casey, let me out right quick.
The family don't want to go to this snow prep race. I figure I go down here and do a little recording and stuff like that. See how things are. So y'all ride with me for a little bit. We'll be right back.
Here we are, another day, another dollar. Sammy's out here. His car's tore to pieces. That's what, you know, LSs do. And we're out here. Nice event put on by Corey. And we're seeing if Sammy's gonna get mauled. Get out my phone here. Get y'all guys a little bit of light. See what's going on here. Sammy, how's the breathing so far?
Yeah, it's good right now.
Is it?
Yeah.
You're getting a lot on your back right now, though. A lot of grass and stuff.
All right, all right.
Dad, go ahead and give him a couple little small... Give him a couple little pops to the chin. Just let him know it's there. Oh! Uh-oh! Get him against that fence right there. Oh, no. Come out the back on you. Thank you. These kids don't need to look over here. It's PG-13 stuff happening over here. All right, I'm gonna turn the lock back on. Looks like you're back on top, Dad. Everybody look over here and see Sammy get walked.
He's still losing.
What?
He's still losing.
Is he? What are you doing? You trying to get him in that arm bar?
No, I got him trapped up. Crucifix.
Do you?
Oh, yeah.
You think he's gonna lose his grip?
He's gonna lose it eventually.
He's getting tired, ain't he? There you go. Oh,
tired.
Young boy tapped early.
Too freaking tired. These clothes killing me.
Yeah. What do you think about the first no prep wrestling championship?
Well, you know, it's a little slippery.
I think them clothes are killing
the traction,
me.
The traction just was.
He got his car hearts off.
Goddamn, I'm hot.
Promotions go out here and have a hard time trying to get 32 cars down the track, let alone 64 in one class and 30 something in another and whatever with another. Like, we got everything done, everything got on the show on the road, and we're out of that place by 9 o'clock. It's winter time, so it is cold. It wasn't super cold, it was bearable. And once the sun went down, or once it started getting dark, the wind stopped, and then it kind of warmed up a little bit. It felt better at nighttime than it did in the daytime. I gotta slow down. I want to get another speed tickets tonight. We're coming through Lancaster. Had a freaking great time. I always have fun hanging out with Colt Howell. Me and him, we get along picking around, jugging around. We always aggravate each other. He told me, the old man won't hit him off with you. Colt was a high school wrestler, a real good high school wrestler, went to MMA and stuff like that. Super strong little dude. We always pick around, joke around. But his dad's a super strong dude. Like, his dad's one of them type dads that I am. Like, was really, so always involved in his son's program. You know, he's always there for him. Even to this day, even with his racing, as you can tell, he comes to the track with him. He's there to support his son 100%, which is freaking awesome. But when you support your kid 100% and you go through and really put forth the effort, if you go to enough wrestling practices, you learn to wrestle. Just like if you're gonna be dumb, you better be tough. You know, if you ain't, like, me and him was having a discussion tonight, if you ain't tough, I hope you're smart and you're very rich. That way you can pay somebody for not kicking your butt. But the cool part is, like, his dad's a super strong dude, like very, very strong dude. Like I had a ball, I really did. I like walk around in the dirt with him. I got these coveralls on, so I can't do much. He had his jacket and all them layers, so he couldn't do much. But we got to wall around, we had a real good time from it. Like, it was hard for both of us. I got out of breath at the end. His toughness outwore my freaking stamina. And I was finally like, after he escaped that crucifix I had him in, my legs were tired, I was tired. When he got upper side control on me, I was just like, I'm good. I'm not gonna sit here and go to sleep because I'm freaking tired. But I had a freaking ball. Like, I really, really did. Like, it's just so laid back and so, like, so much fun. Because we don't let stuff, like, the ego ain't there. You know, it's like, we go here and we go out here and we roll around and we just have fun and we're just good friends. You know, at the end of the day, we're all just there to have a good time, wrestling. Just the weather's good. Like, it wasn't too cold like usually. Corey done a phenomenal job. I really like Corey's races. He gets up there and does the announcing. He knows every single car. Like, he ain't one of these promoters that, like, most promoters don't know who you are. They don't know where you're from. All they know is you, another number, another car, another pavement. Corey can go and get up there and say, that's blah, blah, blah. He's representing blah, blah, blah. He's trying to take the money back to blah. He knows every single car. And I'm not talking about one. I'm talking about 64 cars from people all over the country. I'm talking about the 32 cars that was in the other class. I'm talking about every car. He knows the name of the car, the person's name, the team they're riding with. And he really gets people up there involved, like, with his talking. So I think every racetrack needs a good announcer. You know, I think every racetrack needs that one announcer that knows his stuff. And Corey is that guy. And I have a blast at his races. He's a very cool dude. Like, I'm up there helping Cole out, and he's like, he walks there, he's look at this guy, and he's like, another day. Because he watches, he supports, he's supportive, and that's why we support him. Always support people that support you. That's the people that have your back. There's people out there that don't give two craps about you, that wouldn't give you air in a jug. There's people out there that's going to hate on you no matter what you do in life. You can be the best person in the world, they're going to hate on you. There's people that's going to think they know the worst parts of you that really don't know the worst parts of you. There's going to be people that's going to really think that they really know you and really know what bothers you, and they don't really have a clue. But like I said, Corey does a freaking phenomenal job. Absolutely stellar. Loved it. I love seeing the baddest man on the property. Congratulations, Chicken Hawk. Chicken Hawk took it home in small tire. Casey Max in big tire. And then remember the dude with all-wheel drive, Patterson. Can't remember his first name, but his old Camaro is the car that won the Extreme Street. But just like, it's just a good time. Like, it's good to see the baddest people on the property win. Like, I hate seeing races and people split money. Now, that one in Crossville last week, they split $29,000 between six of them, between five of them. I'd take that payday any day. But I love, from a fan standpoint, I love to see the baddest person on the property take the money home. And tonight, that was Chicken Hawk. He took the biggest load home. The Billy Goat, riding, son. That thing was riding. Everybody, Patches was doing good. I hate to see him go out. Willie Dynamite, all of them all. Willie Dynamite, Patches, that's home team stuff. So, you know, I'm automatically pulling for the home team no matter what. They're right down the road from me. I've known Jared, the tuner, I've known him for years and years. I've known Shannon, who used to own Willie, that Jared bought it from. I've known all of them dudes, so they've been around for a long time. Like, we've all been real good friends, so I always ride with them no matter what. And I hated seeing them get put out, but they some fast cars out there. Some real fast cars, but like I said, it was a real good time. So anyways, please like, share, subscribe, comment. I'll see you one later. Thank you.